pandemic was all about shifting cures. You know, the need of the hour was to quickly adapt to the situation and be there for our employees. You know, the utmost priority was to make sure that we are communicating as much as we can and connecting with them. And, you know, just to make sure that we are there for them and to remove any kind of apprehensions, especially in second wave, there was a lot of fear around everywhere. So, and when I say connection and communication, it's just not, you know, having a lot of sessions. It is also about, you know, picking up the phone and asking every employee who's affected or whose family is affected, how are you? Is everything okay? How are you dealing with the situation? So I would make sure that I would call individually every employee. I would tell the managers to connect to each employee to make sure they're all okay, you know, and for their safety, we had started conducting vaccination drives, not just for the employees, but to make sure that for the families as well. And if there were families who, you know, if there were people who needed financial assistance for their families, we would also provide that. So that is how we did deal with our employees in pandemic. Individually, you know, I had to make sure I am positive. And to do that, I removed all the distractions, you know, which was coming from everywhere. I completely focused on being there for my people, being there for the people who needed us the most, whether it is internal or external. While internal, we were there with, you know, with all the help we wanted to, we could give them. Externally also, you know, because LinkedIn was full of posts, people losing jobs, people, you know, so I would make sure that, you know, if I have a relevant opportunity in my organization, I give them the priority. I contact them individually, asking them to share resumes if I could help them. And if I don't have any relevant opportunity in my organization, I would, you know, refer them to a known organization, a known people, just to make sure that we are there helping each other, you know, in this crisis. Most importantly, the importance of digitization. While I talk about digitization, let me, you know, put stress that HR in itself, the role on HR of HR in itself has changed a lot in this pandemic. You know, we realize how important the HR is. And yes, digitization in HR, you know, we had to adopt various modes of virtual recruitment, virtual onboarding, employee engagement, communication, you know, doing all kind of sessions, engaging them through different types of virtual platform. Okay. Then obviously this brings to the future. I mean, the future of work is hybrid. So we have to, you know, make sure that we adapt to, you know, analytics, digitization and all of that. Plus, there has been a gradual shift to, you know, gig economy. Organizations have started accepting freelancers and part-timers as their, you know, future workforce. And very importantly, you know, this pandemic has made not just HRs, but every leader realize the importance of EI, which is emotional skills, you know, and the importance of empathy. So going forward, empathy would be, you know, a relevant skill which would be required for every manager, every leader, every HR in every organization is what I feel has shifted in, you know, pandemic.